Hi, this is Freddy from Switzerland with another knife review. Today it's going to be a special 2-for-1 review for some knives that I got kind of recently. One I got a little bit longer than the other, but they are the newer and the older version of the same knife with a bunch of different and very important differences to these two knives. There are two knives from a brand that I haven't taken a look at so far, so it's going to be something very interesting and new for the channel. And today's video is about knives from Berg Blades, which is the custom and production knife brand of Matt Westberg, which is a custom knife maker that does a lot of production collaborations of his own designs with Wee Knife. And one of the knives I'm going to present to you is a little bit an older one, and one is the newest one that he has actually released only a short while ago. And I'm of course talking about the Berg Blades Iron Pup that we have here, which is the smaller version of the Iron Wolf, which is going to be a 3.5 or even larger blade size. Here we are under 3 inches. This is the micarta handled bolster version without any kind of the aftermarket custom things that you can do to the knife from Matt Westberg, like Timascus or zirconium clips and things like that. So this is a standard issue, if you can say so, iron pub in micarta bolster blade at 35 VN flat grind, and with all the things you would expect from this knife. And this is the older version of the iron pub. Now we have the satin or contoured pub, which is a thumb stud version, a new thumb stud version of the iron pub design. Couple of differences here is a full titanium handle. It's going to be a little bit heavier than the regular pop here in the back. No internal milling, unfortunately, but you have contour titanium scales. There are two different versions, the satin version like this, or a version that is finished like the blade and the bolster here all throughout is also available for this knife, the satin pop or the contoured pop, as he calls it. Here we have a zirconium clip. The clips are a little bit different on these two knives. You can see here we have a bunch more clearance on the contoured pop, and that is certainly noticeable. This clip works much better than this one in my experience. You also have more ramp here, as you can see, in comparison, a much different and improved clip on the newer pop design. You also have a hollow grind on this blade. Of course, you lose the fuller, so you have space for your thumb stud there. And you have an upgraded steel. This is going to be CPM 20CV. Here we have S35VN. Bearing pivot is the same on both knives. And of course, you have a different kind of deployment. And here you don't have a bolster lock, just a regular frame lock. Everything else is pretty similar. Also, both of these knives are made by Wee Knife. So let's take a look at the specs of these two knives. I will tell you when there are differences. If I only state one stat, it's exactly the same for both of these knives. So we have an overall length on the Berg Blades Iron Pup or contoured pup right here of 6.75 inches or 17 centimeters, which gives us a blade length on both of these knives of 2.75 inches or 7 centimeters, so well under 3 inches and legally in a lot of places there. On the top we have S35VN, and here we have CPM 20CV, which is certainly a steel upgrade. Blade stock thickness on both of these knives is just at 4 millimeters, so certainly a thick blade stock, especially for the sizes of these blades. So certainly something that I would like to see a little bit reduced to about 3 millimeters, but we notice quite a difference in cutting performance on these two knives, which was always a thing that a lot of people were a little bit disappointed in the original iron pup, because here we have a mid-height flat grind on a blade stock of 4 millimeters. Here we have a 3/4 of a height grind with a hollow grind on the same blade stock, and you certainly can notice a difference, even though this blade right here isn't as thin behind the edge as I had hoped for, but it certainly is a much better performer than the iron pup right here, the original one, which of course is a flipper deployment knife. Handle length on both of these knives is around 4 inches or 10 centimeters. Prices on these knives in their stock format without any aftermarket Berg Blades customization options. Here, of course, we had the zirconium clip. The new one, $245 in the stock version here, in the Satin version, and these were around 220, but they are discontinued, so you only can find these on the secondary market now, and there they probably will command a little bit of a markup, so they're pretty much the same probably as a actual price nowadays. And the weights on these two knives are also a little bit different. On the bolstered micarta scaled version, we have a little bit of lighter weight overall of 97 grams or 3.5 ounces, which is certainly heavy for, or heavier for, a only 2.75 inch blade, but not too heavy to carry. And you also get an even higher weight, of course, because you have a full titanium construction with pretty thick handle scales and a titanium backspace. Of course, the zirconium will be adding a little bit of weight as well, because zirconium is quite a heavy material. But you have a weight here on the satin pup, the contoured satin pup, of 107 grams or 3.8 ounces. So still very comparable on these two, but this is a little bit lighter weight than his newer version. I would love to see some internal milling on this contoured pup to get the weight a little bit down, because you certainly have to consider this is an under 7-inch overall length knife, and you're approaching 4 ounces at the weight level there. So that's certainly going into a realm where you certainly notice that you're carrying it. But with everything else you're getting here on this gorgeously designed blade, I think it certainly can make up for it. But internal milling would be something I would love to see on a second run of these contoured pups right here. Then to get deeper into the size comparisons on these knives, let's do our regular kind of comparisons. First off, we have a Para 3 with sharp dressed knives, aftermarket micarta scales. You can see Para 3 is larger overall of both of these knives. Cutting edge is going to be slightly longer on the iron pups, thickness wise. They're actually quite hand-fitting small knives, so thickness is pretty close to a Para 3 right there. Both of these blades even a little bit thicker, I would say. Of course, tip strength is going to vary massively because we have a 4mm of blade stock on the pups. Then we have a Benchmade Bug Out, which certainly is going to be a good comparison. Place it in the middle here so you can see the Bug Out is going to be slightly larger in the handle as well as in the blade. Cutting edge is going to be also a little bit larger on the Bug Out. Bug Out is going to be quite noticeably thinner though. Then we're going to do the Shiro Sandwich. We have on the bottom the Neon Zero, and on the top we have the F95NL. And you can see these are smaller than both of these knives, which is not surprising at a blade length of just 2.75 inches and an even slightly shorter cutting edge there. Now I will show you some other competitive options for these Berg Blades iron pups. And there has not been released a larger version of the thumb stud deployment pups in terms of an iron wolf or something like that, but that should be coming quite soon, as Matt Westberg has said something along those lines. First comparison or competitive option is the Quiet Carry Drift. Gorgeous knife, great things that Quiet Carry has established with the Drift, certainly one of my favorite knives that came out later in the year. And you can see size wise those two are quite similar. We have Vanex steel on the Drift, and you can see you have even a slightly longer cutting edge on the pup right here. Thickness wise you will see much different. This is certainly a much stouter overall knife in terms of thickness, but this cuts like a dream. So there's certainly always benefits and drawbacks on the blade stock decisions. Then we have a MKMT Marvo Vox design. Pretty close in the overall size to these two knives, as you can see. Very, very similar to the pups right there in overall size. Blade stock, similar, slightly smaller, but you can see you have a nicer or more defined, more thinly ground tip on these hollow ground pup right here. Then let's see. A knife that Matt Rashberg compares these knives to is Small Sebenza on his website. And size-wise, that is certainly the case. You can see it's pretty much identical to a Small Sebenza, even though it's going to be quite thicker in all the other dimensions, as you can see right here. But size-wise, it's pretty much identical to a Chris Reeve Small Sebenza. And a couple of others, because I have quite a bunch of these knives in my collection along this size range. Here we have the EZE by Alliance Designs and Ray Laconico, as well as Riyadh. And you can see this is going to be a little bit larger. Also another example of a rare bolster lock production knife. And then my favorite knife of 2017, I believe, also a great thumb set deploying knife, the Vox designed Fox Tur, which is going to be a little bit larger. You can see there is some kind of distortion going on with the camera placement, but these three knives are pretty much identical in overall size. Here we also have quite a thick handle, also very contoured, so these are very similar in blade stock as well as in handle thickness. But this is a considerably lighter weight considering it's pretty much all carbon fiber. And the last comparison is going to be the Peña X Series Front Flipper Trapper, which is going to be pretty close in overall length, but much, much more slender in an overall size. Thickness-wise, you can see these are even a little bit thicker than this one, which is quite thick at 0.5 inches. So these are the size comparisons, a little bit more than usual, but I hope you could get a good feel for the sizes of these knives. So if you focus on the newer version here, you can see you have a very clean overall design, an absolutely gorgeous clip point blade shape that was also one of the main things that drew me to the original Berg blades pop. Here of course have the additional element of a fuller, which certainly gives it even more character, but I think the more cleanly designed thumb stud version is something that I even like more. Also very clean markings, just the Berg Blades logo, which I think has a little bit of an odd place on the blade right there. I would like to see it maybe a little bit smaller and just right there. But it's certainly a cool looking logo for sure. Hollow grind, I certainly appreciate that on this kind of blade. As I said before, slimmed down blade stock would have been a nice choice as well to make this a great EDC slicer, even though as it is right now, you can absolutely notice a quite improved cutting performance to this one here, which certainly was always a little bit lacking in that area because of the thick blade stock and the pretty thick overall flat grind. If you're cutting cardboard or anything with this, it was quite a dragging cut, even though it was quite sharp out of the box. Ergonomically, of course, the rounded titanium handles make quite a difference in comfortability when holding and using the knife, but you get a little bit more of a slippery handle. Maybe if you get the blasted version like this, it could add a little bit more of a matte and a little bit of grippier handle, but in the stonewashed slash blasted handle version of the Satin Pop, it certainly is quite a slippery handle there. But you get some good jimping on top, good forward finger choil, a little bit of traction from the very interestingly executed lock bar cutout there, and overall not really an issue if you're not going to do super hard cutting with this knife, but certainly something to notice. It's quite a slippery and non-textured handle, but that certainly is easily to judge also from pictures. The contouring and rounding is done very nicely. I just close the blade up for a second so you can appreciate the big difference that you certainly notice in hand from a quite boxy, even though chamfered, but quite boxy handle and overall design here on the regular or the first iron pop to the very nicely rounded and contoured handle profile of the new contoured Satin Pop, and that certainly makes a difference in hand. Even though both of these knives have pretty good ergonomics for the size, you know, I have a 7.5 size sterile glove, so small to medium hands fits my hand perfectly. You can see that here. But if you have larger hands than mine, it's pretty hard to fit all your four fingers on there. You can also do a slight foregrip if you have skinny fingers. That works just barely there. But the sharpening child is executed very nicely. You can see here, certainly clears the plunge grind. So that is nicely executed on both of these knives. See right here, nicely executed plunge grind. Great grind overall. Love the satin finish. Two-tone satin, horizontal and vertical. Nice wedge. The design on these Berg blades pop is just something very unique to Matt Westberg, and certainly something that strikes a nice chord with me. Love the overall look of this knife. And I'm really contemplating getting some zirconium pivot colors and maybe even a backspacer to get this knife decked out, because it really feels like a very high-end custom kind of knife. Action on these knives is super smooth, but that was always a strong suit on these Berg blades, Iron Pups and Iron Wolves. He really can work with Wii there to get an absolutely great action. Of course, there are captured ceramic bearings on both of these knives. I think it's the same pivot system that is used on both of these. Nothing that changed there. But you get, of course, a nicer carry in the pocket because you lose the flipper tab right there. And you have a much better pocket clip, in my opinion. That's certainly an issue that you can notice. You also can see that the base part of the pocket clip is slightly shorter and more lip and more accommodation for thicker pants. So clip much improved, cutting performance certainly improved. Lost the flipper tab, went to thumb studs, which I certainly appreciate. More ergonomic in hand with the contoured handle scales. A little bit more slippery, though, for that matter. Upgraded steel to 20 CV. So overall, I would say that the new Iron Pup, the contoured Iron Pup, is my favorite of the two. And I would certainly recommend to get one of those if you're choosing between the two. I think this is the newer end. Also improved version, of course. Both of them have steel inserts, very easy to disengage the lock bar, same kind of thing you have here. For a new version, I would love to see same kind of configuration on this knife with a bolster lock like we have it here, green canvas micarta, and that would certainly dress up this knife even more. But when I get it finally decked out with all these Zerk accents, which certainly is going to add quite a bit of cost to this knife, but I really come to love this in the last couple of weeks when I was carrying and using this, that I feel comfortable on doing the investment here, because I think this will stay in the collection for quite some time, and certainly one of my favorite EDC blades. Just gorgeous, very ergonomic, good clip, nice cutting performance, great steel, and also a very, very impressive action. And also a little piece of exclusivity, because these are at the moment, as far as I know, sold out, but I hope they will come back in a newer, in a future run, maybe with some slight improvements to the things that I have mentioned. Also, great and very ballsy backspacer move right there with the indicator where you can see if the knife is perfectly centered, which it certainly is on the newer pup. On the older one, it's also perfectly centered. So I was always looking forward to getting one of these pup knives because I love the overall design. Didn't know he was coming out with this when I got that one, but now that I had both, I think I'm going to keep this, and we'll probably sell the micarta iron pup right here to fund these Jerk upgrades here and to get something back into the knife PayPal account to fund some future projects. But if you ask me, the newer pup is also the improved pup and the one to get if you like thumb stud opening knives. So this is my review of the Iron Pups, the thumb stud and the flipper version. I hope you liked it. If you did so, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions, leave them down in the comments and I will answer you as soon as possible. And if you want to see more of my content, please follow me here on YouTube and on Instagram at 7ready_knives_reviews. And if you want to get some new knives, check out whitemountainknives.com and use my discount code 7ready to get 10% off your entire order and to support the channel. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.